Hi, paper crafters. For those of you interested in quilling or already doing some quilling, I'm going to just break down some of the things that you can do with quilling combs. So I've got a selection of combs here. In fact, let me just tell you about all the things I've set out here because this is what we're going to use today. So to start, I have a selection of quilling papers. These are from Zuya, and it's something I found on Amazon, and I'm in love with the paper. They're really, really gorgeous. I don't know if you'll get to see that very well. Hopefully you will. But they just have a beautiful thickness to them, not overly thick, but not too thin either. And they're very pearlescent, so they just look rich. And I found that the one downside may be that they're a little on the shorter side. Whoops, little on the shorter side. They're about maybe 12 inches right there. So if you need something longer, I just glue two together. And the results, because of the pearlescence and the richness, you know, I just found that they worked out just beautifully, and I was very, very happy with them. So maybe a little bit short, but the quality of the paper is just gorgeous. So I'm going to use these today so you can see me working with them. I have a selection of colors, and I'll be working with these two colors today just because I wanted something you could actually see on camera really well. So next I have what I pulled out my crimper just because with anything you do with the combs, if you pre-crimp your strip, you can then apply it to the comb and just add that additional element to it. So that's just something to keep in mind if you want a frillier looking design. So I've got a selection of combs here. Only one of them is officially a quilling comb. This is from Quilled Creations, and I love this because the spacing is perfect. The wire metal prongs, I should say, are thin, so that just makes a really nice line. And they do have a longer comb. I just didn't have it. So I just put these together, and I've worked with them before. They work out really great. So I'm just going to show you what I can do with combs from home. But I do really like the Quilled Creations combs. Their super comb, it's a longer one, has a wide space section and then a finer space section. So that's really nice. Now, if you want to have a longer comb but have consistency, then I found just going and picking up a couple of combs worked out really well for me. This is just a Conair. It was a comb that was a comb and brush set, and I just pulled the comb out, and I really liked, see, Conair. I really liked that it was very wide, and I liked that it was a little bit fat in these teeth, because I can make something that's kind of loose bound or just larger in general. So that's just a nice option to have. And next to that, I've got a much tighter comb. This is a comb that I bought at one of the specialty beauty supplies. As a stylist, I have access to this, but I think you could find something similar. But what I liked is that they were very evenly spaced all the way down. I had a nice amount of space to work with. And this is a little finer, so if you're having trouble going into such small teeth and looping in there, you can always double and just go around two at a time. And then these are just a nice medium width, you know, not overwhelmingly thick, not as thick as this comb, but certainly I think a little thicker, just a little bit thicker than these metal tongs. Last but not least, I found this also by Conair. This is a teasing comb. And I loved that I could bring up, I'll show you how I'm going to use it, but I love that I could bring up a piece of paper along here and then loop it back and forth along those angled teeth and bring my paper back and forth and make those beautiful leafy things very easily. So I'm going to show you how I use that one too. Last but not least, I've got a new glue bottle. And I have to tell you, I just haven't really been satisfied with any of the glue bottles that I've been using. So I'm going to try another one and see how this one works. This one's designed for quilling, has a nice pointy tip. So we'll get into that and see how it works. We'll try it out together. So here we go. Let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to do here is just open up this packaging and just give us the preview of this glue. So just pop off the bottom, drop the bottle out. I've got two more items in the box. One is a stainless steel pin, and they recommend that you always keep that in so that your glue tip doesn't dry out. So it says keep in at all times when not in use. Okay, easy enough. And there's my topper. So I'm going to take this lid off. I'm going to put this one on. And now I've got my fine tip top here. Now, what I liked about this glue bottle already, we'll see how well it works in use. But what I already love about it is this metal only comes to right here. So glue can drain down and it's not sitting on the metal. I find that that has been a problem. So I hope that because of their design, that this isn't going to be the same. And then I'm going to just take that little stainless steel pin and pop it on the top here. Whoops. Okay, and that can just live there when it's not in use. So the rest of this I can put away. So now that we've reviewed all these tools, we're going to go ahead and get started. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just shut up and work, and I'll speed it up, put some nice music on for you so we can get through these quickly. There are several techniques that I'm showing you. And after you've reviewed this video, and maybe when you want to come back and find a specific technique that I used, look in that description. I've put in the timeline, by the time of the video, where you can find that specific technique. That way you can just, instead of having to go through the whole thing, you can go right to the time and go right to the technique that you're looking for. So I hope you find that useful, and let's get started.